making that irrational. It's just a short step to supplying a habit.
She hasn't got a habit.
Then why is she in the infirmary having withdrawals? I'm sorry, Jackson. You're under arrest. I'm charging you with possession.
Cecily, ever since I first laid eyes on your wonderful, incomparable beauty, I've dared to love you wildly, passionately, hopelessly, devotedly.
All right.
Now move. You better start explaining.
Well, I had to pretend she was still coming with us. We're not going out by the loading bay door. We're going out through the kitchen.
What about Mervyn?
It's all been set up. The driver's going to distract him while we get onto the truck.
So let's go.
Sister Hall?
No, I'm all right.
Bloody Maxwell.
Yes, if she ever gets back here again, she'll wish she'd never been born. Yeah.
What are you talking about?
Well, Maxwell's gone over the wall.
Yeah, well, good riddance are bad rubbish, I reckon.
I don't know. I'd still like to squeeze the truth out of her about Dope and Spike.
Yeah, she obviously framed you and Jackson for a free ride out of here.
Oh, you're kidding. Oh, gee, that was a mongrel act. How you feeling, Spike?
Oh, you know how it is with smack. I'm lucky there's no more of the stuff around the place.
Don't worry, we'll keep you straight.
Yeah, she'll live.
Come on, tell us what happened.
Well, when I walked in, Jones was trying to get Maxwell to carry all her comics. Well, I took to what was going on and turned around to come and tell you.
Oh, you should know never to turn your back on that bitch.
Yeah, well, that's when the lights went out.
Maybe Merle might see the light. Maxwell's dropped her right in at this time.
Lurie didn't make it.
How do you know?
I was in the shop when the alarms went off.
Is Merle all right?
Lurie, she's too stupid to put one foot in front of the other. She tripped over and sprained her ankle or something.
Did Maxwell get away?
Sure did. Left her mate for dead.
What do you mean?
Looney, when she saw Maxwell was leaving, I thought she was going to eat grass or something. Jeez, it was funny.
Morning, Mrs. Slattery.
Good morning.
How's Merle?
Well, as far as I know, she's all right. You've got a visitor.
Oh.
Are you all right?
Yeah, sure. What, Maxwell back for a visit already, eh?
No, it's a Susie Johnson. You do know her.
Susie Johnson?
Sure. You can go back to your duties now.
She's very strong, Governor. Maybe there should be a man in here.
Thank you, Mr. Adams. I think we've got things under control now.
Whatever you say, Governor.
Well, there's nothing broken. If she keeps a weight off it for a few days, it'll be all right.
Can she ask her questions?
If she wants to, she can certainly hear.
I can't help feeling sorry for her, the poor thing.
We all do, Joyce. But she was trying to escape, and so far she's our only source of information.
Well, it'll only distress Jones if we're all here while you question her.
Yes, Joyce, would you mind waiting outside? I'll call you if I need you.
Sorry, I had to go to that meeting this morning.
There was nothing I could do for Marty at the hearing. I was hoping I'd find out more here.
Yes, well, don't let it get you down. The worst hasn't happened yet.
Mm. One thing at a time, I suppose.
Merle, it's Mrs. Reynolds. I want to talk to you.
Mrs. Reynolds.
How's your ankle feeling?
Oh, it's sore, isn't it? I fell over. And Kath...
Where was Kath going?
We were escaping.
Yes, but where were you going?
Everywhere.
Where were you going first?
To get a licorice ice cream.
But Kath's gone now. We have to know where.
I fell over. But Kath will come back. I know
you
she
want
will.
To come back, don't you?
Yeah, of course I do.
If you tell us where she is, we'll be able to bring her back.
But if she doesn't want to come back...
Do you want to see you? She's your best friend.
You're trying to trick me.
I'm trying to help you.
No, it's Lagan. It's Lagan and it's bad.
Do you know who got the truck?
I won't tell. It's Lagan.
It's not Lagan. They weren't prisoners.
I'm not telling. You can't make me tell, Mrs. Reynolds. You can't make me tell.
You've got 20 minutes.
G'day, Lisa.
Smart ass.
Did you get through?
Reception's like Flinders Street Station. What's going on?
Maxwell had a taxi waiting.
Huh?
Oh, she'll be back. Did you get the stuff?
Sure did.
Choice, is it?
A few photos of Rapid Rodney breathing all over his girlfriend. And a tape recording you would not believe.
Oh, you beauty, Lisa. Girls, I love you for this.
Yeah, move over a bit, will you?
Did you get his performance on tape?
Before and after.
Hey?
You'll be out of here faster than Maxwell when you lay that on him.
Well, don't just sit there. I'll leave you behind.
Please, we've got to get Merle out of there.
Times are tough all over, love. Now get out.
If we'd known how much you liked it in there, we wouldn't have bothered getting you out.
I had to get out, but Merle was just so upset.
You're on your own, so get used to it.
Where are we going?
I'll tell you on the way. Let's go.
Are we going to the airport?
You like things to happen in a hurry.
Willis said he'd get me out of the country.
If that's what Mr. Willis said, then that's what'll happen.
So where are we going?
You're hot. We're going to store you till you cool down.
I want to speak to Willis.
Look, sweetheart. Mr. Willis has arranged a package holiday for you, and you're the package. So just shut up and enjoy the ride.
Sign out here. Oh, Pat, have you seen the new roster sheets?
Sorry, Mrs. M.
What did you say?
I'm sorry I made a mess of them.
What did you say your name was?
Johnson.
I'd say it was Mullins.
Some news for you. A friend of ours just dropped in with a little present. Something to stick the wind right up Adam's.
Lisa?
Yeah, but you should have seen her.
What's she look like?
No, one thing at a time. She was in disguise.
What as?
Well, I don't know. She had a blonde wig on. Dolly Parton, maybe.
Oh, she bloody gun. Hey, did you bring any booze?
Will you stop thinking about your gut?
What do you want?
What's going on? You heard some news about Maxwell?
Sure. She's got her house up at Surface and she wants you to go up there and join her.
Get stuffed.
So what did Lisa give you?
She's got a recording of Adams in his latest starring role. Lisa says it's a classic. He's gonna die when he hears it.
I'd like to see you, Connors.
But I haven't had my lunch yet.
That's all right. When Mrs. Reynolds has finished, you won't feel like eating.
What's it about?
None of your business, Jenkins.
Oh, he's a real wild man, isn't
he? Doesn't take much to amuse you lot, does it? If you had half a brain between you, you'd be dangerous. Come on.
Wow. I don't know, girls. Maybe they're going to give me the Oscar.
I didn't mean any harm, Mrs. Reynolds. It was just a joke.
If you want to visit someone in Wentworth, there are procedures to follow.
Yeah, well, I was missing the girls, and I was frightened if I asked your permission, you'd knock me back.
So you decide to violate your parole?
Oh, well, it wasn't exactly the crime of the century, was it?
It does seem odd that you sneak into Wentworth just as a prisoner escapes.
Oh, no way, Mrs. Reynolds. I wouldn't give Maxwell the time of day.
You seem to know all about it.
Look, Rita told me that Maxwell had escaped. That's all. I swear. I'd be crazy to have something to do with that.
But you can see how it looks.
But it was just a coincidence.
Well, I hope for your sake your parole officer agrees with you.
You're not going to tell her I helped Maxwell escape, are you?
Fortunately for you, I can't see how you could have had anything to do with it.
Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
But I will have to report your little charade.
She won't send me back in here, will she?
I hope not. We've had quite enough of you for one day. But it will be a black mark against you. Nobody wants to see you back here. But any more violations and your parole officer won't have any choice.
I won't be back.
Connors to see you, Governor.
Thank you, Mr. Adams. Miss Mullins is leaving. Would you take her to reception, please?
Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
Come on, Mullins.
I hope you realize you put your friend's parole in jeopardy. Must have been something very important to make her take a risk like that.
It was nothing. She just bumped into an old mate and wanted to tell us how she was going.
Which old mate was that?
Lexi. Lexi Patterson.
Funny Mullins didn't mention that.
Oh, it must have slipped her mind.
Or perhaps you just didn't get your story straight.
Well, maybe they're going to come down hard on all of us because of Maxwell.
So why just talk to Rita?
Oh, well, she's top dog.
And I bet they found out something from Merle.
She wouldn't nag, would she?
Well, who cares if she did? We had nothing to do with it.
They're not just the escape. Well, what's to stop Merle spilling her guts about everything?
Oh, well, she knows to keep her trap shut.
She's not too bright, and she'd be real upset about Maxwell leaving her behind.
Hey, maybe she told him about Maxwell planting the smack.
You reckon she knows?
No.
Yeah, well, she wouldn't lag on Maxwell, but I don't reckon anybody else is safe. If they've got her doped up, there's no telling what she might say.
Well, let's just hope they keep her in the infirmary where nobody's listening.
Yeah.
Oh, well, if that's lunch, I've had it.
Yeah, I'm going to see how Rita...
Oh!
Oh! Are you all right?
Oh, hell, Mrs. Pringle, it's me ankle. I think it's broken.
Oh, I think we'd better get her to the infirmary.
Yeah,
up here. Oh, now, don't put any weight on it.
Oh! Oh!
Where are we?
What you've been dreaming about, sweetheart. Wide open spaces.
Can you be more specific?
No need to. You're a package, remember?
Look, I didn't do your boss a favour just to be treated like dirt.
And we didn't break you out to listen to your whining. Matt! Your company's arrived.
Who's Matt?
Are you here?
Yeah, only one of them made it.
But what happened to the other?
She fell down. I had to leave her behind.
You tell Willis I want her out of there.
Look, you really should be grateful that you got out yourself. Your friend, she had a chance.
He's blind. You're going to leave me with a blind man?
I'm leaving you with my brother. And if you give him a hard time, the only travelling you'll be doing is straight back to Wentworth, understand?
Forget it. She just didn't expect it, that's all.
I'm sorry. I wasn't thinking.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah, you remember what I said.
You coming in?
Nah, I got to get back. Rob's keeping me busy.
See ya.
Yeah.
When are you coming back?
When it's time to go. Social calls aren't part of the deal.
Coming in?
Yeah, that hurts a bit.
She really went down like a ton of bricks.
Well, I would have expected some swelling.
Oh, I'd probably be all right.
Sit back.
Now, you make sure you do what Sister Hall says. It's for your own good.
Sorry. She'd better rest here for a few hours, and if the pain doesn't go away, she'll need an X-ray.
Do you hear that, Tucker? No nonsense about getting off this bed.
Don't worry, I'll rest it.
Well, make sure you do. A sprained ankle can be a very nasty thing.
I'll be back after lunch to have another look at it.
Oh, it'll be right. I don't need all that nursing stuff.
Oh, you're such a brave girl.
Don't you bother Merle. She needs her rest.
Merle. Merle, can you hear me?
Kath.
No, it's not Kath, it's Brumby.
Quicker.
Now listen, if anybody asks, I wasn't trying to escape with you. It was just you and Maxwell. I had nothing to do with it, right? Just you and Kath, right?
Wildly. Passionately. Devotedly. Hopelessly.
You're cheating the deck.
Mel Gibson needs your heart out.
Hey, let's hear it again.
Okay.
Hey, give us another look at them photos too.
Lisa's got the nigs. We can wallpaper the place with it.
Hey, check him out. Oh, I just banged all look like that once.
What sort? He's going to have to be put on a league too when he gets a gander at these.
Okay, here we go.
Cecily. Ever since I first looked upon your wonderful and incomparable beauty.
Hey, what have you got there?
It's none of your business.
Was that a woman?
Oh, what a shame. Now we're all going to have to go to work.
The show's over.
So the gawkers can get lost.
Hope you've said goodbye to lover boy, have you, Jenkins? Your boyfriend and the rest of that garbage have been sent back to Blackmore.
You got your facts wrong. Blackmore's still smoking.
They rebuilt just enough to send the men from here. Bad luck in it.
Where'd you get all this?
That's not the only thing that talks around here, and you want to know something else?
What?
It was all your fault. Because of those blokes you lagged on, Reno reckons it's too dangerous keeping them here.
Nobody lagged. I would have fixed those bastards. They were lucky the screws came along.
Yeah, well, I reckon Harry's a lucky one.
With your key, you could get us together.
Oh, well, you should have thought of that when I first walked in. Now, you can go whisk.
break your neck, you skinny wretch! No!
How much do you want?
The only thing she'll be getting from me is a free fume.
He's only a man.
Yeah, but he's the only man I've got.
You okay?
What's it to you?
Maxwell really fixed you up, didn't she? She gave you a taste. You must want another one.
I can handle it.
Why suffer?
Rita says no drugs.
Collins doesn't have to know if I make an exception just for you.
You make me sick.
And why are you still standing here talking?
Hey, what's going on?
Nothing.
Get over here.
She's not trying to sell you nothing.
If she was, it'd be my business.
And mine. You're crazy talking to that bitch.
Look, Rita, it's nothing. I'm all right.
Okay, you're a big girl. Now, we're going to have some fun.
Well, what do you got in mind?
You and Harry are going to have that talk.
We are?
How?
Spider's key.
We've been through that already.
But this time we don't ask permission.
You're going to nick it?
Yep.
You know where it is.
Right. And before you go out on skip this afternoon, you'll know where it is.
Sure you won't have one?
I'm sure.
Doesn't look too good, does it?
Well, at least he got bail. That's a start.
Well, at least some good will come out of my suspension.
What do you mean?
I'll be able to spend my time looking for Christine Dunn.
Look, Marty, that's the worst thing you could do. Looking for her is how you ended up in court this morning.
But that just proves I'm on the right track. I mean, if someone went to all that trouble to set me up just because I asked about it, she's got to be important.
And because of that, the police are looking for her so you can forget about it.
The police looked for her during Marsh's case. Why should they have better luck now?
Why should you?
Because I believe Marsh's story.
And where has it got you? Possession of heroin, supplying inmates with heroin, committed for trial on the above charges, and what do you learn? What advantage have you gained?
I know it looks bad.
Could the police do any worse than what you're doing?
No, I guess not.
So let them do their job, right? Don't get in their way.
I suppose you're right.
The most important thing is not to have any contact with Marsh.
But if I can prove that
Listen, mister, you take my advice or you find somebody else.
Can I help with anything?
No, I prefer to do everything myself. If you start moving things around, I won't know where anything is.
Of course, I wasn't thinking.
That's something you'll have to get used to while you're here. Everything has its place.
I don't think I'll be able to eat anything.
Too excited?
I suppose it's exciting. I just wish there was something I could do for Merle.
It sounds as though you were very close.
She needs me to look after her, and I left her behind.
Eat some of this. It sounds as though you need the energy.
Thanks, it looks very nice.
Now look, you must never, ever lie to a blind man. You just can't get away with it.
I'm sorry, it's not the food. I just feel so guilty.
Well, what did you make it out of it? A broken ankle or something? It's not the end of the world.
But I left her behind.
Well, it seems to me you had no choice.
I could have stayed with her.
Look, I wasn't always like this, you know. A mate and I were breaking into a warehouse through the roof once, so I want to hear you eating while I'm talking too. We were sprung badly. The night watchman heard us and telephoned the police. We ran for it, but I fell off the roof.
And you hurt your eyes?
Yes. Damaged both optic nerves. My mate, he got away, but I had to do a bit of time, and that was the end of the eyes for good.
That's supposed to cheer me up?
Oh, you left your mate. My mate left me. I understood, so will your mate.
She won't understand. She's like a child.
Well, it seems to me that I know everything about Merle except her friend's name.
It's Kath.
Pleased to meet you, Kath.
Hey, where have you been? I've been waiting for you.
Venison parole officer, what do you want?
You seen this?
Maxwell's escaped, so what?
Well, don't you see?
Look, I had a bad day. I don't feel like playing 20 questions.
Someone's done Maxwell the favour of breaking her out of Wentworth. Why?
Maybe they got a kid that wants killing. I don't know.
Because I reckon Maxwell's the one who set Margaret and me up. And now she's got a reward.
You got a pretty good imagination.
Well, think about it.
All right, it adds up, I suppose.
Of course it adds up. It's obvious.
You reckon? Anyway, well, we're not going to be around to find out.
If you keep your ears to the ground, you're bound to hear someone boasting about it.
Let go of me. You're not going to get me involved again.
I thought you wanted to help her.
I do. But I don't want to end up dead or behind bars.
Well, have you been threatened?
Only by me parole officer.
About what?
Look, it's got nothing to do with you, but if I make one more wrong move, I'm back inside.
I've got to do something.
Yeah, well, do what I'm doing and stay out of the way. You heard what those guys were like when we started asking questions. What do you think they're going to do to us next?
We can't just give up.
Yeah, well, I can, Mr. Jackson. So get lost.
What do you think you're doing, Jenkins?
Oh, I was just delivering the clean laundry, Mr. Adams.
Getting off by yourself and loafing, more like it.
Oh, come on. I thought I'm working me feet off.
Well, you can certainly do with the exercise, can't you? Now, get on with it.
Well, if you get out of me way, I will.
That's more like it.
Who's the actor now?
Hey, Mel, are you all right?
I can't get up.
I've got to talk to you.
We're going to escape and find Kath.
It's too late.
But I've got to find Kath.
We're mates, aren't we?
Yeah, but Kath's my best mate.
Yeah, well, everyone knows that, but you wouldn't want to get me into trouble, would you?
I want to get up.
Listen, nobody knows I was in on the escape, Mel. You won't tell them, will you?
I won't say nothing, but I've got to tell Rita, because she's top dog and she'll help me find Kath.
No, you can't. You can't tell anyone.
I want to get up.
You've got to promise me you won't tell anyone, not even Rita.
I want to get up.
Well, I'll be your friend like Maxwell. I'll read your comics to you.
Kath wouldn't let him tie me up like this.
Well, if I take the straps off, will you promise not to tell anybody that I want to escape with you and Kath?
Can't cross my heart, but I promise.
And you won't wreck the place?
I just want to get up. I always get frightened when they do this to me.
And I had nothing to do with the escape, right?
Yes, you did.
I mean, you won't tell anybody.
I said I wouldn't.
It's a deal.
And you'll read comics to me until I find Kath?
And you're not going to say a word.
What's going on in here?
I gotta get up.
Lie down, Mel. Come on, you need to rest.
No, I gotta find Kath.
Just lie down. Nobody's going to hurt you.
No, you're going to send me to that place.
I don't know it.
No.
Leave me alone. I'm not going to say anything.
We'll miss you, Merle.
Sister Hall certainly will.
Save your sarcasm for someone who really appreciates it.
I just think your sympathy's a bit misplaced, that's all.
Look, Sister Hall will be perfectly all right in a day or so, but that poor girl where she's going, you know how she hates it.
She was just a time bomb waiting to go off. It could have been you or me.
Goodbye, Merle.
Don't worry, I'll look after her.
Look after yourself, mate. She gets an arm free, she'll rip your head off.
I'll be careful.
Well, she certainly won't be strangling anyone else for a while.
If there were a home for insensitive pigs, you'd certainly be in it.
Oh, thanks. Should keep me going till I hear from Marty.
Haven't you heard anything yet?
Well, he said he'd phone as soon as the hearing was over. I suppose if the worst comes to the worst, his lawyer will ring. Oh, it won't come to that. You'll be hearing from Marty soon. I can't help feeling guilty about Merle Jones. The one thing she was most frightened of has happened to her.
It's not your fault. I mean, she could have killed Sister Hall if Tucker hadn't been so quick in yelling for help.
Tucker has a lot to answer for. If she hadn't released Merle from the restraints, we might have been able to control the girl.
Oh, I don't know. Once Maxwell left Merle behind, I think it was only a matter of time.
I suppose so.
Heard about Sister Hall?
No, but she was talking when the ambulance left, so there can't have been too much wrong.
It's a lucky escape.
Yes, I really had no choice but to send Merle away. That's one girl we've failed. Well, you better bring Tucker in. I'll hide the evidence.
Tucker, Mrs. Reynolds is ready to see you.
Well, Tucker, I'm sure you know why you've been called in here.
Yeah, you want to thank me for saving Sister Hall's life.
There wouldn't have been an attack if you hadn't released Merle Jones. I was thinking of a charge.
A charge? After I busted a tonsil screaming for help.
If your throat heals as quickly as your ankle did, you've got nothing to worry about.
That's adrenaline. Well, when I saw Sister Hall lying there with Merle hanging onto her throat, well, I just stopped thinking about the pain.
Adrenaline?
Yeah, I read about it.
I didn't realize it could work such complete and permanent cures.
Yeah, it surprised me too.
Sister thought she heard you talk about a deal. I want to know why you went to so much trouble to get into the infirmary. And I want to know what that deal was. And I don't want a lot of nonsense about adrenaline either.
Did you find out what the ambulance is for?
Screws aren't talking and nobody else knows.
What don't you know?
About the ambulance.
It was Merle. I was picking up some stuff from admin. Saw her being taken through reception. She was a wreck. All drugged up and strapped to the trolley.
Well, where was she going?
I don't know. Screws wouldn't tell me, poor kid.
Off to the loony bin. Where else would they take her? Just for trying to escape. She would have been screaming for Maxwell. They probably wanted some peace in the infirmary. Hey, Brumby's up there. She'll be able to tell us what happened.
No, she was outside the governor's office. She looked real worried.
She must have seen what went on.
I suppose we'll find out sooner or later.
Yeah, well, I reckon things are better off without her. That's where she belongs, in the bin, her and her Captain Marvelous.
Shut up, Spider. You'll end up blowing bubbles all afternoon. Hey, you all right?
Yeah, I reckon it's just a hangover from the poison.
Did you get it?
Little beauty.
Just where you said it'd be. She's not so smart. She's getting dumber by the minute. You ready to roll with this thing?
What, now?
Yeah, well, you want to see Harry, don't you? Well, I haven't got my makeup on or
Come
nothing.
Well, I thought it was cruel to leave her there like that. Well, she promised she wouldn't do anything stupid.
And what about the deal?
Deal?
Sister Hall said you mentioned a deal.
Oh, that. Well, that was the deal.
What was?
I just told you. If I'd let her go, she wouldn't play up.
In the short time you've been at Wentworth, you've tried to escape twice that I know of.
Well, what's that got
to do? I thought the deal might have something to do with her keeping quiet about your collaboration in Maxwell's escape.
I never did, and if Mill said that, she's lying.
Jones mightn't be as clever as you think you are, Tucker, but she doesn't often lie.
Well, she doesn't know what she's talking about, then.
Is the new punishment cell ready for use?
Ready and waiting.
Oh, why me? What have I done?
I'm not convinced you're telling the truth about Maxwell's escape. But even without that, releasing Jones in the state she was in was an act of criminal stupidity.
She's got you to thank for being sent to the mental home.
You mean she's gone?
Yes.
You might take time out to feel sorry for her while you're doing your punishment. Now wait outside. Joyce? Tucker's outside my office. I want her put in the punishment cell. Yes, it's the least she deserves. Thank you. She knows more than she's saying.
Well, we've questioned most of the women, with the usual response.
Yes, could you get me the minister in his office, please? I'd better let him know what's going on. The last thing I need now is a ministerial visit.
Oh, you're not kidding.
Anne Reynolds, could I speak to the minister, please? Yes, all right. Thank you.
What is it?
His secretary's going to get him to ring me back. At the moment, he's busy with Miss Joan Ferguson.
What on
earth? I don't like to think about it.
Now, judging by this, you've made yourself quite an enemy.
Well, she was just another crim at Wentworth. I didn't treat her any differently.
Beecham obviously doesn't see it that way. She's taken it personally.
I don't care about her feelings. Can't she back up her threats?
Well, if it was only Willie Beecham, I'd say it was a lot of hot air, but she spends her nights with Maxwell, Terri.
Never heard of him.
Well, the money he spends to keep his name out of the papers, I'm not surprised.
Well, can't you put pressure on him?
We are talking about one of the richest and most powerful men of the city. He looks after his friends, but he's not the sort of man you cross.
Oh, he's just another criminal, for God's sake.
Some of his friends could have me out of this job with a 10-second phone call.
Well, then get Beecham and keep your name out of it. For God's sake, she's an ex-con in charge of a security firm. Surely your department can handle that.
The department can't be seen harassing reformed criminals. The media would crucify me.
And if I tell them everything I know about you, they'll crucify you anyway.
Don't you threaten me, Ferguson. Just take my advice and go back to Wentworth.
Oh, come on, I'd be a laughing stock. I can't go back there.
Doesn't have to be forever. Give it 6 months, Beecham will probably have forgotten all about you. You don't have any alternative.
Why does she want to come back? She said she'd never work with me again.
She must have had a change of heart.
I doubt it. Joan's always made her attitude to my reforms perfectly clear.
Well, you can't expect all your officers to agree with you all the time, Mrs. Reynolds.
No, but I insist on loyalty and support.
I'm sure you'll get them.
If I do, it'll be the first time. I am trying to make Wentworth a modern, humane institution.
I understand your misgivings, but you're both professionals. I'm sure you'll work this out between you.
Wentworth is not the only prison in the state, Mr. Dwyer.
I'm afraid you don't have any say in this. Miss Ferguson withdrew her resignation, and I'm returning her to her former post.
If she comes back, she will be so closely supervised, she won't know whether she's an officer or a prisoner.
Well, it's up to you to manage your officers the way you think best.
The smallest transgressions will go on her record. I've given her the benefit of the doubt in the past, but that is over.
Very sensible. I do exactly the same thing myself. Well, you can expect her later this afternoon. Oh, and thank you for your cooperation. Well, you're in, but you might have been better off against Beecham.
I can handle Reynolds. There's just one more favour, though, before we're through.
You've used up all your favours.
Now, you listen to me, Dwyer. I lost my job and you came out of it smelling like a rose because I shut up about you. Now, just one more small favour, or we might both be looking for work.
This is the last time.
This place is a bit dicey, isn't it? Screw could walk past any time.
Check it out, Lurch. He's complaining already. We picked a quiet place last time and your mates tried to rape us.
You know I didn't know anything about that. Bastards knocked me out.
Relax, Harry. You're like a bridegroom on his wedding night.
I'll leave him alone, Reet. The library and the storeroom have been cleaned out.
This'll do. All I have to say won't take very long.
It better not. I'll keep knit.
They're sending you back to Blackmore.
Yeah, could be any time. A few have left already. I didn't want to go without telling you about me.
You said you're in for rape and murder.
That's right.
And you said you did it.
It was a pack rape. I was just as guilty as all the others. But I didn't do it.
Eh?
I was there when it happened.
And you didn't do it?
I didn't stop it either.
Oh, I knew you couldn't do something like that. Oh,
you're a good Sheila, Alison. I want to be straight with you.
You are, aren't you?
Yeah, but you make it sound as if I was innocent and I wasn't. You've got to know the truth. I was out with a bunch of mates from the trade school.
Yeah?
We were drinking at the pub with a couple of girls and everybody got really shickered. One of the girls said she wanted to have a party. You know what I mean.
All of yous.
So, we took her down the park and... Well, she changed her mind. But the blokes didn't.
What did you do?
Nothing. But I didn't say a word and that makes me as guilty as hell.
But I don't reckon you're like that now. You seem sort of strong, you know.
I've had a long time to think about it. Doesn't make me strong.
You wouldn't do something like that again, would you?
No.
So you're not the same guy?
Hell, I hope not.
Will you write to me from Blackmore?
I'd like that.
Mightn't be for a while. They might have a gold phone there. We could call each other.
At Blackmore?
Got to keep in touch. I reckon this is something special.
I'll write all the time.
If you'd behaved yourself, you might have been the first to use the flat instead of being locked in here.
Well, I got all I need. A bed and a blanket.
It's more than you deserve.
Yeah, well, life's tough, isn't it?
For poor Merle, certainly, if you really want to know.
Well, you can't blame me for that. She was playing with a short deck before I came along.
Do you know what you need, madam?
Nothing.
A sense of responsibility.
Well, gee, I sent off for the coupons about 3 weeks ago, but they ain't arrived yet.
Well, I hope you can keep your sense of humour while you watch the others enjoying themselves. Over there.
Who needs it?
Connors, you're a bit out of your way, aren't you?
Yeah, I just want to stretch my legs a bit. Any news from Mr. Jackson?
No, not yet.
I will cheer up, he'll be all right.
It's easy for you to say. Have you seen Jenkins anywhere?
No, she's doing rounds with the skip. Why? She got a visitor or something?
Oh, I've come to tell her she's getting use of the flat tonight with a woman from C Block.
Oh, she'll be wrapped. If I see her, I'll tell her.
Yes, well, you do that. Now, I'll take you back to work so as you don't get lost again.
Yeah, time is getting on, isn't it?
No, not that way.
He's on the phone.
Marty?
Yes.
About time. Right, get a move on.
Gee, I hope it's good news.
Oh, it's
Saved by the bell. Geez, that was close.
God, it sounded like Burke Street out there.
Did you hear what Morris said?
She was looking for me.
You're getting to use the flat tonight.
Me? I'm the first one.
Yeah, so you don't want to get sprung in here, right?
Yeah, Reet's right. You don't want to blow it.
Geez, I wish you were going to be there with me.
Yeah, me too. But it's not on. I've got to go.
6 months?
We'll be writing all the time.
You won't laugh at me spelling.
How could I laugh? Your letters will be the best thing in my life.
Come on, Lurch. If we get sprung, you'll be spending the night in a pound instead of the flat.
I don't bloody care. I won't be seen again for 6 months.
Yeah, well, I care, Alice. I want you to look after yourself. Besides, I might still be here for a few days.
Oh, how can he miss you if you won't go away? I'll write me first letter tomorrow.
See you, love.
What's this 6 months business?
It's when I'm due for parole.
And you're going to come and see her?
If she still wants me to.
I don't get it. You've only met her a few times.
Look, I don't know why I feel the way I feel, but I do. Your mate Alice has got under me skin, and if you won't believe me, tough.
I just don't want her hanging around for things that ain't going to happen. Like people who can't be bothered writing letters.
You don't have to worry.
I must be an idiot, but I believe you.
I'll worry about her more than you will. You'll be here and I won't.
You're all right, Harry. And don't worry about the old Lurch. Alice. I'll see if she's right.
Come on. He's finally called.
Oh, I take it the news was good.
Well, at least he was given bail.
That's a relief. Now let's hope he has the sense to stay at home and stop playing detective.
Well, he's certainly taken his time. The hearing was over ages ago and he's only just called.
Maybe he needed the time to get his head together.
Well, he knew how worried we all were.
Well, don't push it, Meg. Won't help. He's got a good lawyer. The police are investigating. The facts will come out.
I wish he hadn't heard about Maxwell's escape.
Why is that a problem?
Well, he seems to think that she was the one that put the heroin in the locker. Well, she didn't just walk out, did she? I mean, someone had to organise that, arrange the getaway truck.
And he thinks that someone could be returning a favour.
Well, makes sense, doesn't it?
It's a possibility.
Well, on the phone, he was treating it like another clue.
You'll just have to tie him up until this case is over.
Well, I don't think he's that desperate. He seemed to listen to reason.
Yes, well, I've got some news too. Joan Ferguson's coming back. I tried to tell Dwyer I wouldn't have her, but he made it very clear I've got no choice.
So we're stuck with her again.
And that's not all. He phoned me back with his list of prisoners. They're to be transferred as soon as the paperwork's through.
Rita Connor.
They've all got one thing in common.
They've all had a run-in with Joan.
How's Big Rodney's surprise coming along?
Ready to go any time you want. Just give me 10 minutes to set it up.
I thought you wanted to be left alone.
Yeah, well, if you run out of talk, there's some work to do.
It's nice to know we'll never be unemployed.
Bob Hawke should give Simpson the medal, I reckon. Yeah, well, if they gave medals for people having to listen to rubbish like I do, I'd have a chest full of them.
Wait till Lurch is safely in the flat, then it's showtime for Officer Adam.
Lurch won't like being left out.
Well, if she's there when it happens, he'll just put her on a charge. We can't take the risk.
Yeah, we don't want to mess her big night out. No.
Aren't you, missus?
You must be joking. Hey. Brumby's in the punishment cell.
What?
Yeah. Reno reckons if I talk to her, I'll get kicked out.
What the hell happened up there? Reno say anything?
Just told me to mind my own business.
Well, when you're down there, you can find out.
Oh, I don't know. I don't want to stuff up my night in the flat.
If I know Brumby, she'll have her say.
Yeah, well, if she says anything, I'll let you know. Hey, I have a lot to write to Harry about.
You're allowed to have mates up there, aren't you, Lurch?
Yeah.
Who are you going to invite?
Hey, Simpson, what are you doing tonight?
I'd rather spend the night at Dunny.
Now, I please me visitor, and I'll watch the late movie, and the late, late movie, and the late, late, late movie.
Well, there goes the neighbourhood.
Hey, we was worried about you. What's going on?
Jenkins, you've been told don't talk to the prisoner in the punishment cell.
I just thought I'd come down here for some peace and quiet. But if I hadn't known the circus was coming to town, I wouldn't have bothered.
You're just jealous. Oh, jeez.
You've caused enough trouble for one day, young lady, so just leave Jenkins alone.
Oh, yous have really sucked her in, haven't you?
What do you mean?
Oh, well, look at her. She thinks she's outside.
Well, she's a lot better off than you are in here.
Yeah, well, at least I know where I am.
Hey, check out the speakers.
Oh, oh boy, I have to have a go at this.
You've got plenty of time, Jenkins.
Oh, yeah, but I don't want to waste any of it, do I?
Brumby, you're really missing out. The matches is this thick.
Jenkins.
Yes, Mrs. Pringle.
Jenkins.
Oh, this week's beauty magazines.
Jenkins, pay attention,
yeah,
please.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Look, we mustn't get overexcited, must we?
No, I won't.
Yes, well, remember, you've got to keep the noise down and no more talking to Tucker, because if you do, you'll be sent back to your dorm.
Oh, don't worry about me. I know the rules.
Right, now, just get all these things tidied up, shall we? Ready for your new flatmate.
Oh, yeah, well, we want to keep the place looking spanking new, don't we? Hey, Mrs. Pringle.
Yes.
Who's going to be in here with me?
Oh, some woman from C Block, Martha Dimmock.
Martha Dimmock? Oh.
How's it going up there?
Just a few more seconds.
Screw.
Oh, damn.
G'day there, Mrs. Pringle. How's it going?
How's what going? I'm not a mind reader, you know.
Lucky for us.
What's that?
We were just wondering how Lurch was getting on with her luxury accommodation.
Oh, she's as happy as a puppy.
Wagging her tail, is she?
Oh, now come along. You know you're not supposed to hang around the corridors.
Hey, can we visit her?
Well, not until after dinner, and not unless she asks for you. It is her privilege, you know.
Oh, dinner, I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah.
Any idea what the man of the house is serving us up tonight?
As a matter of fact, it's a sausage surprise.
What's the surprise?
There's no sausage in it.
Oh, that's very funny. I must tell Mervyn. No sausage in it.
Don't tell him where you got it from, though.
Yeah, we want to eat tonight.
Yeah. You're coming back into form, kid.
As long as I keep busy.
A cultured woman like yourself can't imagine what it's like in here. Their idea of fun is warming up the mud before the wrestling starts. But I can forget it all just by looking in the limpid pools of your... Thank you for calling. Yes, I will. Goodbye.
Sounds to me like spring is coming a little early this year.
I don't know what you mean.
Well, if you've got a secret, it's perfectly safe with me.
Don't be ridiculous. You're here to relieve me, I presume?
That's exactly what I'm here for, so you'd better get on your rounds.
I thought I better warn you, Joyce Joan Ferguson's coming back.
When?
She'll be here any minute now.
But I thought she'd resigned.
Just send her straight to my office when she comes in.
Great.
Well, she's going to notice that things have changed a bit around here.
I've got my rounds to do.
It's nearly there.
Oh, careful! What do you think you're doing?
Gerda's express is on the way. Just came through the security gates. Are we ready?
Is the tape rewound?
Yep.
Then we're ready. Oh, damn!
Well, stop your ass, Simpson.
Let me go,
Mr. Adams, you know, stand still. That's better. Now, the department has spent a lot of public money to provide you people with a gymnasium to exercise in. So no running in the corridors, right? Right?
You say far up yourself, you must have used a step ladder.
You just made the biggest mistake of your life.
Sexy?
Well, I did say it was you.
You bitches! You've gone too far!
Everything in the world is grey and dark. It's a sight for sore eyes.
But soon you'll be deputy governor, won't you? I can change all that.
Hang on, you'll love an exhibit, girls.
Oh, don't cough, Ernest. When one is dictating, one should speak fluently. Besides, I don't know how to spell a cough.
Cecily, ever since I first looked upon your wonderful and incomparable beauty, I dared to love you wild, passionately, devotedly.
I'm going to kill you bitches for this.
Silence! What is going on here?
Thank you.
give me roses. I wish he could again, but that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines.